project that Crisis we've been wanting to do for a while, and luckily it turned out Centrepoint also wants to do exactly the same thing. And part of this is motivated by the fact that the leading cause of homelessness now is no-fault end of a tenancy in the private rented sector, and the fact that people simply can't afford to cover their rent, especially if they're dependent on housing benefit. So a big part of this is the fact that the way your housing benefit's calculated has been adjusted, made less generous, and then frozen. And we've got a couple of slides that cover the exact background of what happened, which are arriving just in the nick of time. So it's really complicated to work out your benefit entitlement and to analyse it. It depends on lots of factors, but the relevant one here, and we are only talking about England in the analysis we've done today, is what broad rental market area you live in. So there's an amount, the local housing allowance, which you can claim, which is defined by that area, and these areas aren't used for anything else in government, and also by the property size. And if you're under 35 and in the private sector, you can only claim a shared accommodation rate, which is designed to allow you to rent a single room in a shared property. So that's what all of this data we're showing today focuses on. So originally those rates were set to the median rent in your broad rental market area. Then it was revised down to the 30th percentile. Then they capped the rises to 1% a year. Then they froze the rises, and we're now in the freeze 4 years through to 2020. So basically, when you used to be able to get 30% of properties, you're now dwindling down to 20%, 10%. We didn't know what, really. There's a second issue, which is these rates are based on a government-held database of rents in the private sector, which a lot of people think actually understate true values in the rental market, particularly if you're trying to get a new rented property. So something we've managed to do is compare the government source of data on rents to a private source, which was perhaps a spare room, looking at adverts, what can you actually find for those rents.
Yeah, so our mission really was to compare the local housing allowance to data that we found ourselves on Spare Room, where we didn't want to use any other sources because we didn't know how accurate it is, so we decided to go and compute these values ourselves so we know we can trust it. We did a really simple design. Postcode, we hit go, and it will present these bar charts saying what your allowance is and what you can afford, how much you really can afford on Sphere, so the averages of both. We haven't plugged in Zoopla yet, but it'd be pretty easy to do that in the future.
Turns out that Zoopla might move only went down to like studio flat level. It didn't actually go as far as room share, so that is probably not valid for what we're trying to do here.
Cool, yeah, so to talk a little bit about what we did. So we built a sort of web scraping engine thing, which like for those of you who don't know web scraping, is basically emulating a user clicking on the spareroom.com website, clicking through each of the pages of the results, and scraping the data off and storing it in a kind of small system we built. Spent a bit of time doing that, found some filters that returned the right set of results, and then we kind of scraped all that information in. Into our application.
Yeah. Oh, and then so one of the other bits we needed was this is like the kind of distribution of rents that the government uses to calculate the LHA, and this they released this, but it's a bitmap which is like less useful in the PDF. So we wrote a scraper that like takes the bitmap and converts that into the actual value, so we can compare them to numbers.
Cool, so yeah, status of where we're at. So I've now got the poison chalice of running the live demo, which may or may not work, as we discovered. So as Rory alluded to, we're hitting Rightmove quite a lot and pulling up a lot of data back. So it's been a little hit and miss over the last half an hour.
Don't undersell it.
As to whether Rightmove will let us do this.
They might have just blocked us.
Be bold. Be bold.
But we'll see. So so what we've got here is the mock-up of the Centrepoint website as an example of where where this little application could be used. So we're just going to scroll down. So we've now introduced this this very basic search for postcode application. So I'm going to type in a postcode. I'm going to press go. It's going to pull back a lot of data, so it will take a few seconds. I was kind of fingers crossed that something happens in a moment. This is like a normal time frame still. So we've now been off, been over, grabbed the government data, been over to spare room to see like what are the actual properties that are available over there now, and presented this for the user. Just nudge you gently out of the way. So this is the price that the government think is acceptable for SE1, which would be London Bridge sort of area. And we calculated that would allow you access to 0.7% of the available homes on spare room right now. And then done some nice graphing here to see where the government allowance actually matches up to the low and high rates in reality. So blue is the government rate and purple is the real world spare room rate as advertised right now.
Oh wow. What's the lowest and highest?
That's the minimum and maximum rent in the area.
Oh,
yeah.
And these aren't quite directly compared. Well, we'll get onto this in a second.
There's some filter criteria around sparerooms.com, so it's like one bedroom within a house, and you know it's not a studio flat. It's not anything like that. It's being filtered right down, and that's the range of the map.
Well, we're getting a hurry on signal, okay. So we're gonna wrap up with where we finished up with.
Just a few things we need to do to sort of refine that model you saw, which is, so at the moment the comparison between the government data and the spare room, they're not completely comparable. You're looking at a broad rental market area from the government, you're just looking at a postcode sector. Spare room often includes bills, so we need to make some sort of adjustment to see if those are really the same costs. Also, spare room has a useful flag, which is DSS welcome. We found that if you activate that, you get down to about 5% or less than 3% of what was available.
So it goes from 1,000 results to 4 or 5.
And because the government can't draw their graphs, so a cumulative distribution function goes down, we need to adjust those as well, so it actually just is a range minimum to max. Anyway, all of these relatively simple, hopefully numbers somewhere.
Excuse me.
Awesome.
Yeah. This is all based on under 35.
Yeah.
All under 35s, and in the private sector only.
And only in the private sector.
And anyone who would wanting to rent a mixed shared room, right? If anyone wants to be in the shared house using housing benefit, they'd get that rate.
Yes, sorry. Yeah. So if you chose as an over 35 to live in shared accommodation, you'd also be restricted to this rate.
that's debatable. If you talk to St. Mungo's, okay, their studio flats that they're saying are studio flats are in shared accommodation.
That's
so it's
trick.
A manipulation of syntax, and one of the criteria that DPW.
I was just thinking, rather than do an analysis of it now, I'm just thinking, given what we had when we started yesterday, and what these guys got now, it's just
brilliant. Yeah,
so let's not dwell too much on the bits that we've got to count doing. This didn't exist yesterday morning.